Leave it to the director of Kick-Ass to get the X-Men franchise back on track. Thank you, Nasty Vaughn. Seriously, thank you. You proceed in the swagger. You proceed in the swagger. We are bold, you can see it in the swagger. How we walk, how we talk, you can see it in the swagger. He for real, you can see it in the swagger. You can see it in the swagger. He a boss, you can see it in the swagger. How we walk, how we talk, you can see it in the swagger. You can see it, you can see it. You can see it, how we walk, how we talk, you can see it in the swagger. X-Men First Class. So the story goes like this. The first X-Men film comes along and it's really good, it's intriguing, it's got great visuals. A bit underwhelming with the action, but it's still a really good movie. But then X2 comes out and BAM! Right out the gate, epic action, great storytelling, wonderful character development, easily one of the best comic book movies ever made. Then the third one comes out. A lot of people don't like it, which I'm not gonna lie, I thought it was entertaining, it had style, it just didn't hit all the right notes. Then you got the Wolverine film. To be honest, as a cheese fest, I thought it was entertaining, but it definitely brought the series to an ultimate low. So now here comes director Matthew Vaughn swooping in like a true superhero, and he saves the franchise with this awesome prequel slash reboot that turns out to be one of the best Marvel films to come out in quite some time, and quite possibly one of the best movies of this summer. No kidding, X-Men First Class is truly awesome, because I think it's something that everybody can truly enjoy. It's a comic book movie that feels like a comic book movie, but doesn't really feel like a comic book movie. Get what I'm saying? Probably not. I mean, you have violence that's actually quite violent, you have a lot of adult themes, and you have a bit of cursing that you don't expect to hear in an X-Men movie. But you do get some spectacular action, and I mean, there is not a single action sequence in this movie that's gonna have you saying, "That could have been done better." Though I don't know why you would say it that way. Okay, maybe there's a few CGI shots that seem a bit... what the hell is... unpolished. But for the most part, everything looks spectacular. There's just so much cool stuff in this movie, I can't even begin to tell you how cool it is, because one, I don't want to spoil nothing, and two, you just have to see it for yourself. Action and effects aside, this movie has great dialogue, great characters, and performances that keep you entertained and engaged. For starters, Kevin Bacon is back, people! He plays an awesome and charismatic villain that might just be his best role since Tremors. But! Okay, honestly, he's done better stuff, but I just never pass up a chance to reference Tremors. Love it! But the stars of the show are definitely James McAvoy as Xavier and Michael Fassbender as Eric Lynscher. Seeing the relationship build is just as exciting as any action sequence in this movie. Mostly because the actors are brilliant, because they never once try to replicate what Patrick Stewart and Ian McKellen did with the characters. No, they simply brought their own talent to the table and brought something new. McAvoy as Xavier was so great because he brought the cool side out of Xavier. He's young, he likes to drink, he likes to party, pick up on chicks. He's a bit cocky and he cares a lot about his hair. Fassbender as Eric, the man who would become Magneto. He's just on a whole nother level of badass. I mean, honestly, if he didn't have powers, I still wouldn't want to mess with the guy because the guy's intense. But both actors play off each other perfectly, and seriously, that's what got me hooked on the movie. All the other actors are fine too. I mean, Jennifer Lawrence, she was really fine. And she can act too. I was actually surprised too to see a lot of older actors that I liked that make appearances in this movie, such as Michael Ironside and Agent Pierce from 24. Never pass up the chance to reference 24 neither. Love it! So yeah, with great performances from most of the cast, not counting January Jones. She's hot, so I'll give her a pass. Great action, great score, great directing. At some point, this movie actually feels like Kick-Ass, and that's cool. There's a lot of humor, the training sequences were fun. There's one mad-ass, god-ass teleporting son of a bitch named Azazel, and I would not want to mess with that guy. I mean, he takes out like 5 guards with machine guns in like 2 seconds. Honestly, if I was the 6th guy, I'd be like, okay, you win. Unless the movie takes place in the 60s and you have the whole Cuban Missile Crisis thing going on, I mean, you just got an awesome cool villain, you know, because it's the guy that said F you to the Tremor. 2 Tremor references, 1 video. Yes! Seriously, you just gotta see it. It's the best X-Men movie to come out in a while, and it is just awesome. To be quite honest, I can't find too much wrong with the movie, except for maybe a few minor things. Like for me, the first shot of Beast was a bit underwhelming. I thought it was a little silly, but then I got used to it. Plus some other things that involve some characters and some choices they make that I can't reveal because it will spoil it. Just little minor things that I can't quite put my finger on, but just kind of prevent this from being a 5-star film. So with that being said, I'm giving X-Men First Class 4.5 stars out of 5. This is not a minor summer blockbuster. This is a really well thought out, very smart film with some amazing action, great characters. Just go see it. This is Big Gabe with Stuck Burrito Entertainment. Join the Stuck Burrito Revolution by subscribing, liking the Facebook, and following the Burrito on Twitter.